why is Christine obsessed with tea?
Because it's just so hello, it's beeping. It's so delicious.
I mean, have you always been a tea drinker, Christine?
No, actually. No. Do you want to spill sip the tea? Do you want to dip into my past here?
Sure.
So when I was 15, I got addicted to coffee.
Really?
True story. Yeah, I'm not being... Oh,
I didn't know this.
Yeah, I'm sure I've told you, but I worked at my dad's car shop, and they would order 4 cups of coffee a day, like just to break up the day, I guess. That's mm-hmm. what people in car shops do. They go for coffee 4 times, sure. at least where I grew up. So I would always get a coffee when I was 15 years old, which is like weird and not really the healthiest. That's why I'm so short. That's why I'm 5'4". I drank so much of it for maybe like a year of my life. And then I got so sick of it, I never wanted it again. Then I grew up and went to university and everyone's drinking coffee. And that's kind of like where you first normally learn how to drink coffee is like university age-ish.
Yeah, and that's because you're up university all night. Culture
yeah.
of, yeah.
Yeah, you're up all night partying and then you gotta have your cup of coffee before you write your exam. Like that's the yeah. culture. So I hated coffee, but I wanted to order something to fit in. But I didn't order tea yet. Because it was so boring and bland to me. I know, blasphemy, I know. Terrible. But at the time, I was like, it tastes like hay water. It tastes like nothing.
What?
Don't worry, this story will have a twist.
Okay.
But, and so instead, I ordered like fancy vanilla creme frappuccinos or peppermint hot chocolate or
basically
something.
Basically like milkshakes.
Yeah. Basically sugar and milk is yeah. what I ordered. Or chocolate. And then over time... That it became clear that that was not a healthy choice yeah. because I was doing that every day and sometimes multiple times a day, you mm-hmm. know, with my friends who were going for coffee or lattes. And here I am ordering like a kid's peppermint hot chocolate.
Frappuccino.
Yeah. Yeah. And I realized later that wasn't good for me. I was consuming so much sugar and I was drinking it rather than like, you know, eating it in dessert, which is fine. But why would you drink all that sugar? It didn't make sense at a certain point, and I realized it just wasn't good for me. So I made the decision to just cut all of that out and that I wasn't going to drink my sugar. So I decided, well, okay, I need something to drink to sip on. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, like, what am I doing when I, you know, have a story to tell and I need to sip some, you know, tea?
Sure.
So I learned to drink tea. But at the beginning, I thought it was bland and I could only have it with a little bit of milk. So I'd have milk or almond milk or whatever type of milk because I couldn't stand just the plain tea. And then over time, I learned that there was different types of tea. So there wasn't just black tea. There was green tea, rooibos tea, oolong tea, white tea, fruit infusion tea. And then you could experiment with different types of milk. Like not just 1 or 2% milk, but oat milk and coconut milk and almond milk. Yeah. And I started realizing that there was a whole other world of like flavored tea out there. And I slowly grew the taste for tea and appreciation for the hundreds of different flavors and like types of tea and how you could make them taste good with just a little bit of milk. So fun fact, I don't drink any tea without any milk, whether it's real dairy milk or a milk substitute. I can't have tea without something, just like a little bit, just like half an inch.
Well, we just got like a whole tea origin, superhero origin
I've
story.
I've heard people
here.
Ask for an entire podcast on tea, so there you have it. We'll make that a highlights clip.
That is interesting. Like you love tea now, but you took you a while to get into it.
Yeah, to get into it. So I encourage you, even if you think it's not for you, it very well could be. You just gotta
give tea a chance.
Give tea a chance. Take your time. Explore all your options, and it might be the right fit for you. Not sponsored by tea.